We want to determine the given limit numerically, which means we want to complete a table of values where we have values to the left and right of negative 3 that approach negative 3. So notice how in our table we have negative 3 in the middle, and then we have 3 rows above and 3 rows below negative 3. Here we have 3 values that are less than negative 3 and approach negative 3 from the left, and here we have 3 values that are greater than negative 3 approaching from the right. I do want to briefly show how I came up with these values. If this was negative 3 on the number line, if we headed towards 0, negative 2 would be on the right, and negative 4 would be on the left. So negative 2 is greater than negative 3, and negative 4 is less than negative 3. In the middle here, we'd have negative 3.5, and over here, we'd have negative 2.5. So somewhere in here, we have negative 2.9, and here we have negative 3.1. So negative 2.9 is greater than negative 3 because it's to the right of negative 3. And so this is what I started with. And then by adding a 9 in the hundredths and thousandths, we're getting closer and closer to negative 3 on the right. On the left, it was similar. I started with negative 3.1, negative 3.01, and then negative 3.001. So these values are less than negative 3, approaching negative 3. Okay, now that we know where these values came from, now we're just going to sub them into the function and see what the function values tell us. And we're going to do this using the graphing calculator. So the first step is to type in our function. So we'll press y equals. Our numerator is x squared minus 9. And our denominator is x plus 3. Now if we put our table in ask mode, we can just type in these values very quickly. So if we press second window for the table set, we're going to go down to the independent variable and highlight ask, press enter. And now if we go to the table by pressing second graph, we can type in these exact values. So we have negative 3.1, negative 3.01, and negative 3.001. Let's go ahead and type in negative 3. Of course, we're going to get an error because we would have a 0 in our denominator. Negative 2.999, negative 2.99. Let me go ahead and record these in the table. And now that we have this table completed, notice that from the left, as we approach negative 3, we're approaching negative 6. And the same is true as we approach negative 3 from the right. So by using this table, we can determine that this limit is equal to negative 6. And while we're here, let's go and take a look at the graph of this as well. So we're approaching x equals negative 3, right where this hole is. As we approach from the left, and as we approach from the right, we're approaching the function value where this hole would be, which you can see would be equal to negative 6. We'll take a look at another example in the next video. I hope this was helpful.